I'm sad and low, yeah. My name is Daddy Chunk. Ellie left my ass. Suicide, now I'm making vlogs on my ass, yeah. Mukbang stuffing up my ass. I'm sad and low, yeah. Ellie left. Now my views are going down the toilet. I'm sad and low, yeah. LA. Happy Friday. We lit. We not sad and low. Yeah, we're not sad and low. Welcome to Dalvin's Pity Party, guys. Welcome in. Would you like a slice of cake? We're having a mukbang! Welcome to the pity party!
Did my invitations disappear? What I put my heart on every cursive letter? Tell me why the hell no one is here. Tell me what to do to make it all feel better. Maybe it's a cool joke on me. Whatever. Just means there's way more cake for me. Forever. Casted out a spell, but told them decorations weren't the story.
Maybe it's a cruel joke on me.
Whatever. Just means there's way more cake for me. Forever. It's my party, and a curtain on the ceiling. I got guns to the candles, go on.
Hello, hello, welcome, welcome. Hello, my good, good Judies. We are back loud, live, and forever in color with Rainbow TV. And I am your fairy king, Bodak. And we finna get into some things, oh. How y'all like the new intro? How y'all like it? Is it giving what it's supposed to give? Bring it to the stage, Penelope, a.k.a. Sarah, a.k.a. in the world, because, you know, she is Sagittarius. This bitch got multiple personalities, child. Come on up.
Good evening. I'm so fucking glad the work week's over. Oh, my God.
Amen to that.
So.
How was everyone's week?
It was good. Training went well.
Oh, you're in training?
Yeah, this week, Tuesday's my official, like, first day on the phone.
Okay, so you working from home?
Yes, sir. I'm working from home.
Are you excited? Are you happy?
I am excited.
Well, you know, that's good that you're excited. There's people here that are, you know, sad at their job. So we're throwing a pity party. So welcome. You know, it's just unfortunate that people, you know, saying that the grind never stops, but in the midst of them grinding, they leaving a tear of fucking trails. A trail of tears. I'm sorry. Minaj, stop doing all that, girl. But, yes. So, did you see Dalvin's latest video, girl? Why is every thumbnail he looks like he's sad?
Oh,
bitch, did you just sneeze
God.
On me? Bitch, cover your fucking mouth. Bitch, it's coronavirus and monkeypox out here.
No, it ain't. Fuck?
The yes, book. It is, bitch. See, it's bitches like you that's always spreading germs and shit.
So how about I showed my boyfriend that clip of me and you to where we was like, out of wedlock, out of wedlock. He thought that shit was so funny.
You know what? I'm finna get all of, like, I'm finna soundbite everything in my lives and stuff, and I'm finna, like, repost them.
That's what I'm saying. I sent him that shit. He thought it was hilarious. I was like, we were, like, in sync to out of wedlock, out of wedlock.
No, you gotta send it to me.
I'll send it to you.
Most definitely. But did you watch his last video?
Yeah, I think I did. Let me see.
Look, you don't even remember, child.
Well, I've been busy with work, so it's like, hold on. Mm. I think I heard about it though.
And you know what's so crazy? It's just like, it's unfortunate that, like, if I ask you, like, oh, have you seen his new video and stuff, you can't even come and have, like, a new opinion because it's, like, the same commentary every other week with this boy. It's, like, you know, giving him the same advice, giving him the same critique, giving him the same response. It's, like, nigga, why is you sad? Why is the world falling? The sky is falling.
Oh,
you
just... shit. But he posted something today. I screenshotted it.
He got requests and
somebody has my name in their mouth. Yeah, because he be watching the fucking T channels and shit. And he's watching now. So everybody say hi to Mr. Dalvin. Hi.
Come on. 1, 2, 3. Hi, Zaddy Punch Punch.
Hi, Zaddy Chunk Chunk. Hi.
Hi, Zaddy. Look, let's give him all his name. Hi, Daddy. Hi, Zaddy Crunch.
Yeah, hi,
Crunch.
Mr. Fat and Pathetic. Mr. I live in a high rise I can't afford, and I'm 30 years old, and all I do is eat on camera. Yeah, hi. Fat and Pathetic. Hi, I'm 30 years old, and I have no hobbies.
Hi, my name is Dalvin, and you know, I want to go to the police academy because I want to be Officer Chunk Chunk. You know, it's Officer Chunk coming in, Roger Copy. Is Dunkin' Donuts still open right now? Because I'm
feeling Mr. Dalvin, we know you in the bushes and we don't fuck with you. Bye. Hi.
Hey, look, you know how Respucio and Norbit was like, is this cherry or strawberry? That's Dalvin when he gonna be at Dunkin' Donuts. With two motherfucking donuts on his fingers, talking about some, is this cherry or strawberry? It's a mukbang, bitch. Yeah. So let me get my little weed together, child. So Minaj, go somewhere. I'm putting to put that toy up. Can you hear that toy?
Yeah, I can. My dogs are put to bed. They're asleep.
Why do your dogs got a curfew? That is so weird. Let me tell you
what my dog did today.
What happened, girl?
So I have six dogs, right? So the four of them, we took them out to just run and shit. Tell me why my boxer takes off running down the fucking cornfield. We couldn't fucking catch her. I'm like literally walking down fucking cornfields and shit. I'm like, Jesus. Like, I was and then I'm calling her fucking name. She's not answering. So I went into the house, grabbed two pieces of bread, and she still didn't, like, oh my God.
You just told us a whole bunch of information that we just did not give a fuck about.
Wow, really? Wow.
Hello, good morning. Bitch, how's the coffee taste?
Good, delicious.
Does it have enough creamer in it?
Actually it didn't. It was a little too parched.
Oh, was it sweet enough for you?
No, it was not.
I'm sorry.
We need to make a song. I watched your performance. That was hard.
You watched my performance of me rapping and performing?
Yeah, it was good.
Oh my God, thank you. So everybody, see, now we talk about something, girl, with substance. So y'all, if you haven't seen, I posted on my YouTube, you know, Penelope's a real ass bitch. Why the fuck am I hearing shit in the background, Penelope?
You said, like, let me find out.
Bitch. Don't be playing shit in the background.
Yeah, that was a great performance.
Thank you, bitch. Can we talk about it without you playing shit in the fucking background?
Okay.
Bitch, you know I'm crazy. I got zero patience for bullshit.
You said, anyways, let me find out.
Play Money. Shout out to Penelope.
Play Money Plays got Wi-Fi. Let me find out.
Oh, bitch. Let me talk, ho. Shout out to Penelope for being a real ass bitch and being obsessed with Bodak. You know, that she fucking goes and supports the doll. You know, she watched my motherfucking performance. I'm sure she enjoyed it because I was killing it on stage. You know what I'm saying? Because I really do this, y'all. I really, you know, make music. And I'm not talking about, I ain't a regular bitch. Let's get that clear, okay? I could write a diss song about motherfucking Zaddy Punch Punch right now and go viral with it.
You really could, too. You have a nice voice, too.
Thank you.
Well, I didn't know my song came through. Let me find out.
Let me tell you what happened. A bitch phone was off, right? And I was, like, going to these, like, open mic performances and stuff. And my partner, who I perform with, he's not as good as me. But he wanted to have like such a solo career, but he didn't have the motherfucking talent or the skill. Let's talk about it. If you watch the video, you can see, you know, everybody I showed the video, they asked me, is that your, what you call it? Your hype man? I'm like, no, that's my partner. They're like, where's his stage presence? You know what I'm saying? But
yeah, he had no stage presence at all. He's standing there like a bump on the log. You up there moving and grooving. Let me find out. I said,
let me tell you about that one particular time when I said, let me find out. Okay, look. So this is the backstory. I said that because my partner was like, you know, I was rushing to these like performances like at one point because I had lost my job. And so my partner would give me the money to come to the like pay for my Ubers to get there. But I guess he was like feeling like, you know, he could do it without me. And every time you go to an open mic, you don't have to perform. Especially like I said, if you don't have the stage presence or the skill. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you need me, bitch. You wouldn't want to get on stage by yourself and embarrass yourself and embarrass the motherfucking brand. You know, we're a new group. We're trying to come up. Please don't do that to me. Because, bitch, the moment you get up there and embarrass yourself, I will not stand next to you. You want to go solo, bitch? Just let me know, bitch, and I will exit stage left. So anyways, we have songs of our own, but we put them together collectively because we're a group, you know? And he was always trying to be in competition with him. It's just a lot. It's a lot. But anyway, the point is, so I couldn't play the mother one of my songs that I just recorded because my phone was off and I couldn't. And so my partner was like a low-key hater. So I'm telling him, like, you know, like, send the song. He's like, I already sent it. They still ain't got it. I was like, this bitch. So then I fucking connected to the motherfucking Wi-Fi in the building and sent the song. And last minute, the motherfucking song came through. And child, I did my motherfucking thing. I said, let me find out.
I thought that was part of the song. You said, ooh, let me find out. The Wi-Fi working up in Money Play.
I was dead ass serious and I was dead ass hyped that the fucking song came through.
And you was moving and grooving. I replayed that part like 10 times. Let me really find out the money working in Money Plays.
See, that's why I want to get on camera with it, because I know, like, you seeing me be Bodak and you hear me be Bodak is two different things. Like, it go together, don't it?
Yeah, it does. Like, your stage presence was, like, on point. You said, let me find out the Wi-Fi working up in Money Plays.
Right. Because I needed that motherfucking shit to work because I needed to save the show. Do you not understand? After I performed my song Jupiter, people was coming up to me after asking me, can I be on their radio station? Like, are you serious? People wanted to know who we were because of me. And I'm finna drop a motherfucking song called Fendi Prince pretty soon, guys. I don't know. I feel like when I first started, you know, going live and stuff, I should have dropped it then. And then I don't know. So I don't know. But hold on. Let me play a little snippet since we here. Let me play a little snippet of the motherfucking song, y'all. But so what did you think about the performance? You liked it? You enjoyed it?
Yeah, you said, let me find out the Wi-Fi working up on Money Play.
You just like my commentary. You ain't said nothing about the song or the rap, bitch. You just like me talking, bitch. What the fuck wrong with you, Penelope? I love Penelope, y'all. I really do.
You said, let me find out.
I was excited. Do you understand how excited I was that my song came through?
Yeah, I could tell. You kept it real professional.
Professional?
You kept it real
you
professional.
You stupid.
You said, let me find out the Wi-Fi working up at Money Plays.
You know, when your phone belay play, you need that motherfucking Wi-Fi now. Shit.
You said, let me find
ain't
out.
Ain't nothing like McDonald's Wi-Fi when you need that shit, bitch.
Came through. Let me find out
the
Wi-Fi working up in Money
Plays.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Okay, because that's listen, I went to an art school, so I'm good at acting, all kind of shit. So it's like when I get on the stage, I just go into that mode, bitch. I could be a comedian, bitch. I could be a rapper. I can't be a singer, bitch. But bitch, I'll lip sing the fuck out some shit. You think I was Millie motherfucking Vanilla?
Oh. Yeah, I wish I could sing.
You know, it's so crazy. My partner was so horrible. I even told him, I was like, let's just do a Nicki Minaj song and pretend it's our song. Okay? And you know that helped him with his stage presence because, you know, we love Nicki so much. Like, he made me fall back in love with Nicki Minaj because at one point I was just like, she went away for a little bit. And then when she came back, it was just like, I don't know. But it's like he was so obsessed with her. It made me all obsessed with her all over again. And I saw how much energy and enthusiasm he had when we used to rap Nicki Minaj together and shit like that. And so I was like, let's just do a Nicki Minaj song on stage. Like, fuck it. And we did a Nicki Minaj song. And when I tell you you would have thought it was our song. Like, people was actually shocked. The funny part about it is we did the Nicki Minaj song on a different beat. On like a original, like, fucking random beat off YouTube. That's what we did the song to. And we did that song, Yes, Bitch, Yes. That was our motherfucking song. And I strategically picked Yes, Bitch, Yes because I knew two gay niggas on the stage singing, Yes, Bitch, Yes. Yes, Bitch, Yes. Me, I'm just me. Me, I'm just real. Me, I'm that bitch that be footing the bill. Okay. They fell for that shit. They thought that was real live motherfucking us.
What do you think of the Nicki Minaj and Big Lotto beef? When Nicki Minaj is like, oh, Big Lotto, you 23, looking who? Like you 40.
Who?
Nicki Minaj and Big Lotto.
Who the fuck is Big Lotto?
Bust it like a wheelie.
You mean Mulatto, Miss Mulatto? Where is she big at?
That's what her name is, Big Lotto.
Ah, she lied to you. She lied to you, baby. Her name ain't no motherfucking Big Lotto. Ain't nothing big about that little girl. Okay, y'all, so look, I'm finna play a little snippet of, you know, a song I did with my motherfucking, with the boy on stage. If you have not seen me perform at Money Plays, go in YouTube, type in Money Plays Open Mic, Money Plays Open Mic, and you will see me. I'm like the first bitch. Was it hard to find me? Oh, wait.
It wasn't. You say, ooh, let me find out.
I'm not finna play with you, girl.
The Wi-Fi working up in Money Plays.
Okay, I actually performed this song before, I think, on my line, but I'm just gonna give y'all a little snippet because I'm gonna drop the shit officially. Okay.
Uni. Kendall. He wanna get him a can. He wanna sit in my Benz. He wanna meet my friends. Yeah. Fuck him then never again. He blew a check on his body.
He blew a check on your body.
Got that but F's on your body. Huh?
Yeah. Duke Carter. I'm the number one starter. Period. Name another nigga harder. Jugs older than me and Paula.
He like the way that I dress.
He like the way that I taste.
I think this little bitch pressed.
She know I sit on his face.
That part. Finny Prince. Diamonds on me, I'm a prince. Dolce Cabana. I feel like Madonna. I know I'm a monster. He like the way that I curve. He like the way that it. I like the way that it turns.
Okay. Okay. He like the way that it purr. He like the way that it. Ooh.
How do you record your music? We should do a song together.
So what do, girl? Do you rap? Do you sing? What do you do?
I rap.
Minaj, you didn't have to bark, girl. Didn't nobody ask you shit. Okay, spit a verse right now. Let me hear some.
Ooh, what a play. One way.
No, bitch, I'm sorry. We will not ever do a song together.
I mean, if you gave me the lyrics, I definitely could do it.
No, but that's because you play too much. I don't know if you're serious. I can write you a verse easily, but
okay, if you can write me a verse, then I
yeah. But my thing is, you ain't gonna have me working for nothing, bitch. I could write a verse, and then your ass really don't take it serious.
I would. Okay, we spit
recite some Mulatto lyrics or somebody lyrics that you know, and I want to hear it like you as a rapper, like okay. Spit that shit.
Okay, let me try to pull. Out of wedlock.
No. See, I'm not going to play with you. Ooh, I take my music serious. We cannot sit here and ask me to put you on a song or something like that and you not taking it serious. Like, I do this. Like, this is serious to me, girl. I don't play about my motherfucking music, bitch.
Okay, but I can't write. So if you give me.
Okay, I told you to recite a fucking lyric from one of your favorite songs. Like, just spit a verse. I want to see if you have potential.
Give me an example.
See, you want an example of shit, Penelope? You play all fucking day. In real life, I would be able to play with you all day. But on here, bitch, you do too fucking much.
Wow.
You kill me every time you try to get in your feelings. Wow. Like your feelings hurt. Bitch, you do play too fucking much. Calm the fuck down, Penelope. Bitch, if I tell you to do something, do it. Now spit a motherfucking verse, bitch. You just was talking about Mulatto. Spit one of her songs.
With a play with a banana. You see me riding. Oh you God. Never knew what I had for you, bitch.
Oh my wait, God. Wait.
I can't say.
Penelope. You do too well. What is this song you trying to speak? With a way. With a play, with a pay. Penelope, Penelope Pelope? Like, what? Penelope Pelope? What a way, what a way. What are you saying? Oh, my goodness. Okay, I'm going to give you an example. I'm going to do Lil' Kim. When she was like, hot damn hoe, here we go again.
Hot damn ho, here we go again. Spitting bars looking like chocolate liquor. By the way.
Okay.
By the Penelope. What'd he say? He can tell I'm missing all meals. Come through and fuck him in the automobile. Let me eat it with the girls. You can tell him in his family. You can tell him in his family. Like that is saying.
Penelope. I need to hear all the words. I need to hear pronunciations. I need to hear, girl. It's one. I know you know one song by somebody that you could just sing the song.
Oh, right. Okay, I know one.
Okay, go.
Real ass bitch, give a fuck by that nigga.
Oh my god, you know that song is old as fuck, and you be sitting here saying that song every time I turn around. Spit the verse in the song. It's young and I can't rub my stackers. Tired ass hoes on my page trying to attract us. City girls planning, we ain't fucking with no ratchet, period. You bitches weak and you serious? I hit the dashboard, now you acting like delirious. Bitch, I made the words up, girl, and it still sounded like the motherfucking song. Coming on, Penelope, Penelope, Penelope.
Real ass bitch, give a fuck by the nigga. Babe, Birkin, Bassin, 5'6" figures, stripes on the sides because they caught this spooky dude.
Hey, I hear it a little bit. Okay, Penelope, no,
yeah, bro. I got it.
You got it, but I don't want you to get in the studio talking about something. If you do that shit, I'ma fight you, girl.
I don't even say that. That's not in my vocabulary. I don't think that's funny.
But you be saying shit related to it, girl.
No, I don't. Like what? All I be saying is real ass bitch, give a fuck by the nigga. They barking back in 5'6" figures. Boom bada boom bada bam bam bam.
Girl, let me tell you something. Look, this time my verse go on the song I'm finna drop. It goes, walking this bitch with automatics for any of you hoes that's getting. Wait, hold on. Bring that shit back. You can't give them to them dry like that. You gotta get that shit wet first. Like, come on now, Penelope. Run that shit back, Penelope. Penelope, run it back.
Okay, so what do I say?
Oh my goodness. I'm over you, Penelope. You're fucking fired. You're fucking fired.
So you don't think I could really spit bars?
No, I told you to run it back. Run the beat back for me.
Okay, do it again.
Oh no. No, you're fired. Girl, you don't work here no more. It's over. Go work from home.
I'll just go back to the bushes.
I'm just kidding. Bitch, I chopped all my bushes off, bitch. You have to sit in the grass.
True. You exposed me. You brought me out the bushes.
Girl, when I came on the motherfucking scene, I exposed everybody. This is how my verse go. Look, this is how my verse go. This is how you need to be spitting this shit. You need to practice it. If I write a verse for you, girl, you got to really practice that shit and do your big one. Okay? Okay, so... it go, walking this bitch with automatics for any you hoes that's throwing shade. Bitch, you a thot and you late. Can't fuck with you niggas because niggas be fake. Eat my dick, say my name, all on my page. Yo, what is your wage? I'm starting to feel like Dalvin is gay. If he broke, can't sit in my face. Tie him up, then I'm running the state. I get paid to show off my face. Your pussy is going to waste. Take your bitch, you can't take mine. Hit your nigga on my FaceTime. He give me head, call it FaceTime. Then ride him good like the baseline. Don't play me poop. You know I'm like that, shooting a movie like DVD. Cause I listen to Rock and I Party with Punks. Got him thinking that it's PMP. He wanna get him affection. He just like an erection. All the trade in my section. And all of them carrying weapons. Finny Prince. Diamonds on me, I'm a prince. Dolce Gabbana, Cabana. I feel like Madonna. I know I'm a monster. He like the way that I girl. I like the way that it, ooh. He like the way that it purr. Okay?
Yeah, that's way too advanced for me.
Let me tell you. I'm going to tell you the secret because I teach bitches how to rap. I taught the motherfucking nigga on the stage to be rapping with how to rap. Okay? He'll tell you that. Look, the code is you just remember the lyrics like, you know, like an acting or whatever, right? Or like your favorite song, you remember the lyrics, right? Once you remember the lyrics and you say them flawlessly, you add your personality in with it. Once you say the shit so many times, you start seeing more, you'll start saying it like, start say it like you're talking, you know what I'm saying? Add Penelope, big Penelope, you know what I'm saying? You gotta add
Big P on the track.
Big P on the track. Okay. You gotta get in your
When he look at me, he don't want what do I
oh my god. Penelope, just stop. I'm gonna write you some lyrics, okay? I got you. I'm gonna write you some lyrics. You're not gonna get in that motherfucking studio freestyle now.
Yeah.
What is the what's in the way? What do you why you wanna keep saying with a way, with a who? With a why, with a what? What is that about? Why do you keep resorting back to that? What is the fuck are you looking for?
No, but remember the day when we was on live and we was like, out of bad live?
Yes, we're gonna have more moments like that, girl. Like, let that pass, girl. You said you recorded it, you soundbited it. That was a moment. It happened in a moment. You gotta let things happen in a moment, girl. You can't keep living in the past, Penelope. Okay. Don't worry, we're gonna have more extravagant moments.
Yeah, because that was on point too.
So do y'all like the commentary where it's me and Penelope? I feel like Penelope matched my energy. She's so playful like me. Like, it's so crazy because y'all be hearing me go off on people. But it's like, if you put a person like Penelope in the room with me. Play it. Let's get into it, girl. Let's get into it. That's it?
Yeah, that was funny.
That's it, Penelope. We said that shit longer than that.
No, because then I started spitting my own thing after that, remember? And I started laughing. You was like, girl, what is you laughing at?
No, because we used to both started remixing it and saying different shit.
No, ma'am.
No ham.
No ham, no twank, no spanky.
No turkey, no bologna. Okay.
No cheese.
So, okay, at this part, y'all, okay, look, we're finna get back on topic, Penelope, and then we're finna, like, reel back to us, you know, kikiing or whatever. So, what I want to do is I'm going to talk about Dalvin's video for a little bit. And I also want to react to a person. I was, like, on, y'all, you know, I was supposed to watch a scary movie the other night, but I was too scared to watch it. I am going to lie, capping. I'm really scared of scary movies. So, I didn't watch it, but I ran into some people's videos where they was talking about Dalvin, and I feel like it was such an unbiased opinion. You know what I'm saying? I give everybody and everyone a fair chance. And I like to hear different people's perspectives. You already know that me and Penelope got the same, you know, kind of commentary when it comes to Zaddy Punch Punch. But this is somebody else who is an older woman, more respectful, not here for the kiki, you know. Just, you know, an older lady giving her perspective. And I want to get into that. But before we get into that, I want to talk about his last video. And I want to talk about the sympathy in payola. Okay, so. Oh, my goodness. Why I got the wrong motherfucking notes? Like, what? Bitch, did I even take notes about this? I did. Hold on, let me go find these motherfucking notes. So, Penelope, did you watch it?
His recent video with the.
Yes. So he was
getting to me? No. It was bullshit. I probably skimmed it.
Yeah, the thing is, it was a clickbait video. And it's so crazy because, and I just put all these papers in here and mixed them all together. I don't give a fuck. I'm not finna look for no motherfucking notes. He don't even deserve no motherfucking notes. He lucky I take myself serious to even do this shit because the fuck, we freestyling this shit. So basically, it was motherfucking clickbait. The title of my video is Dalvin getting his karma and did Ellie silence Dalvin? Me personally, I feel like he is getting his karma because it's so funny how he took two of my TikTok channels. He over here in my motherfucking bushes on YouTube stalking me. So, I mean, hey, I be watching his video, so it's equal. He could watch mine. But my thing is, I feel like he getting his karma. You sitting here trying to take my channels, trying to silence Bodak. But Ellie fucking put her foot on your neck and you've been quiet ever since. And you know how like when you finna act like you finna punch somebody and they flinch? That's what Ellie did to Dalvin. She act like she was gonna say something. She act like she was gonna do something. And Dalvin been in flinch mode this whole time. Like, you know how they been, you know that movie Remote where they pause you? He been face all scrunched up. You know how he do all his faces? Just imagine Dalvin face all scrunched up flinching. And you pause it. That's his motherfucking face right now. He just stuck on skin. He's stuck on scared. Like, what does Ellie motherfucking know that got this boy quiet? This man is on hush mode. And it's so crazy because I finally realized that when I was watching the lady's videos, when she said, because she was responding off the video where she said, we need space video. It finally let me realize that he tried to paint a narrative on their way of breaking up. Like, he tried to paint a picture for us instead of just being real. He started putting certain little videos out, letting us know it wasn't working out. And then when he finally made his, like, apology video after, I don't think he made an apology video. He made his video talking about why it didn't work out. And he said he been checked out. Like, I told y'all that. It's so weird to me of a man saying, I checked out. I checked out, like, a long time ago. Like, you checked out? Like, what does that fucking mean? Like, coming from, like, how does a man check out of booties and titties and vaginas? Please tell me, y'all. I mean, I'm gay and I would have never checked out of Ellie, especially if she was cracking my crab legs and wiping my mouth with the napkin and opening doors for me and massaging
sucking
my feet.
Sucking your nasty, disgusting dick. Ooh.
Girl, why you made me throw up in my fucking mouth?
He had a lift of his belly gut.
He couldn't even see her when she was doing it. Ooh. He just saw her, all that bushy ass hair in his stomach. Mm. Child. But yeah, it is just like she really was going hard for you. And when you say you checked out, that means you wasn't going hard for her. And we saw that, and the stuff that this lady was pointing out was like so good. But another thing is, it's just like she really got that man spooked. I never seen Zaddy Chunk Chuck so spooked. I bet you when him and Nicole broke up, I don't even really remember how, like, you know, the sequence of events. But I bet you that man was smiling on her way. Because I remember a little bit, he was smiling. Oh, Nicole got her new place. And then smile at her and she'd be like, yeah, guys, I got my new place. Like, this nigga. You know what I'm saying? And then it's like, he was so cheerful to go to her little small ass apartment from his 8-bedroom house, drive his Benz over to her house while she in a fucking Toyota Honda Civic. No, I'm just playing. I don't know what the fuck that lady drive. But you know what I'm saying? It was giving very much so. She downgraded. She didn't upgrade, but he just wanted to look down on her and act like he was better. And he couldn't do that with Ellie because Ellie on an island. Ellie taking trips. She in Miami. She meeting Island Boy. Got her an Island Boy. Meeting soulmates and shit. Every time you turn around, Ellie got a new soulmate. Shit. Everybody in my comment section and in his comment section is an Ellie soulmate. How the fuck we all become Ellie soulmate overnight? Like, that bitch putting motherfucking island voodoo on us, some African hoodoo on us. Nah, but, yes. And I just feel like she really got, like, she really got that man shook. What about, what you think, Penelope? You think that Dalvin, like he's saying that he's working on himself and this and that, but why wasn't you working on yourself before Ellie, like, you know, threatened to expose you? Well, she did expose him. I want to go to the comment section. Do you want to go to the comment section with me, Penelope, on his latest video? Yeah. And see, like, the stuff that people were saying?
Yeah, because, on the recent video?
Yes, on the recent video, girl. That's what made me want to really low-key talk about it, because the people in the comment section was eating him up, girl. They was eating his chunk.
One comment said, just be a better person. You wasn't saying this until it was made clear the type of person you are. Just be better, bro.
Now go to the comment section, because bitch, I'm in that hole. I ain't gonna lie, I'm in that comment.
You comment.
Let me go to their replies. Go to that comment that you just read. Go to the replies.
Okay.
Tell the truth and nothing but the true pink. Let me go to it. She's taking long.
Yeah, because now I can't.
Okay, I'm finna read a comment. It says, beautiful, gorgeous, lovely says, you're attention seeking. if you're not cut out for this, stop filming. Simple. How do you feel about that comment? Penelope. Okay, Penelope's weird. She likes to check out at random moments. So, how do you guys in the comment section feel about that comment?
Wait, hold on. I see you.
He said, somebody said, yes, he's looking for sympathy. Sharon Young said, girl, his mom's videos are just as bad. Wait, what? I didn't see this. Three sheets to the wind all the time. Where do you think he learned this behavior? Well, I do see similar things that they do, but it's different for a woman to do it. And I'm not giving her an excuse, but I'm saying, like, it's just certain things. Like, if you are a woman and you boss your man around, or you, like, sassy with your man, or, you know, be, like, very much so a diva with your man, that's different. But when you're a diva and sassy with your woman, it's kind of like, what? Like, women deserve a little bit more respect. Unless you're gay. Then y'all on the same playing field in my eyes. So, bitch, I shade a bitch. I'll do whatever the fuck I want, bitch. I'll read a bitch down. Caboodles come back. And dare a bitch to try to read me back. The fuck? But a woman that I don't know or that I like or something, I'm not going to be reading her or belittling her. The fuck? That's weird. So, this is what I said. I said, he is too old for this. Move. I said, he is too old for this. He can't pretend to be happy. He can't even pretend to be happy. Look at his mom's videos and look at your mom's videos and take notes. If this was your business, elevate and stop begging for sympathy. I said, immature, grow up. It's so funny because Lee Carson said, hang in there, buddy. And I just put a laughing comments under his under his reply because that shit just killed me right there. And then I said, this nigga act like he do construction work. But he talking about he wanted to be a police officer.
No, Dalvin's just full of shit because he knows people are over his bullshit.
Right.
You know.
I wish you would have watched the video so you could have like a little more feedback.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is what it looks like when you turn down going to see a therapist shaking my head.
Shut up. That's my comment. How many likes did it get?
I know. Sure.
It does because that's another thing.
22.
22 likes. So 22 people agree with me. But at the same time, I'm pretty sure more than 22. This man sat there and talked so down on fucking going to therapy, but he's steady coming to YouTube with a puppy face. I really think he need a puppy and he need a blunt. Like, that's really gonna cure his motherfucking situation. Nigga, smoke the blunt, sit your ass down, watch your Disney Plus, and attend to your puppy. The fuck? Let's see. I think I found another comment. Oh, no, I didn't. So, Drew said, do anyone even... Oh, this is a good comment. This is the one I was telling you to look for. This is where all the comments was at. It was 39 fucking replies, Penelope. How the fuck you ain't find this shit? You just read the fucking comment. Okay, so look, I'm acting like Dalvin, y'all. Let me stop. I'm treating Dalvin, I'm just treating Penelope like Ellie. Penelope Belly?
Yeah, so you about to get cut the fuck off.
Don't cut me off, I'm sorry.
You know I'm a Sagittarius, we don't play that shit. We don't come with no type of warnings. You will be big block.
Girl. Okay, look, it says... Somebody said, oh, this is another thing. I figured out that a lot of people watch Dalvin's videos, but they don't watch the full video. They watch that nigga say, what is it, what is it, this is your family. This is my bang. What is it, what is it, what is it? What is it? They watch that man say, what is it, this is family. We're back at it again with another what? And move, bang. Guys.
But did you
We are. You see how he'd be having anxiety? He'd be like, we are back again with another video for who? You. Because it's a banger for another bang. It's like, nigga, do you got OCD or ADHD mixed with Patron?
But did you notice in the recent video that we're looking at, he didn't go so hard in the beginning?
He didn't? You're saying he didn't?
No, he didn't, because he knows we be saying shit about it.
Oh, yeah. That's another thing. You're how you see YouTube and up and you be knowing. I swear, everything I say about Dalvin literally critiques and tries not to do it in his videos. And then one time, some girl said in his comment section, he replied to her, so I seen it with my own two eyes. She said, oh my God, you always say, all right. He said, LOL, I'm gonna stop saying it. But on my TikTok, I think she probably would be offended because on my TikTok, I swear to God, I did a video where I was clipping everything when Dalvin was like, all right. But he was doing it with the food in his mouth. And every time he'll do his thing, I'll do a thumbnail, and then he'll put, smash like 10 chicken wings in the mouth and say, all right. And they was dying in the motherfucking comment section. I mean, screaming. Like, I promise you, like, when I tell you Dalvin made it his motherfucking agenda, that man can't do nothing in life, but he could take a motherfucking page. He could take a motherfucking page down. I promise you, that man can't go take his own stuff out to eat, because he even said in that video, this recent video, he's scared to go out by himself, like to a restaurant. He thinks it's like he's unable to go sit at a table and order some fucking food and feed his fucking face. What is he saying? Run it back one more time. Run that shit back. Turn that shit the fuck off. Turn that shit the fuck off. Why did he say it like that? Why should look? Now we talk about it. Why she come back? What it is, what it do? ZCC family. What it is, what it do? He gonna be pronouncing them words separate. What is it? Like, nigga. What did you speak in Spanglish? That nigga speak in cursive. What it is, what it is. What it,
because you know Dalvin be in the bushes, so everybody, hi Dalvin, hi Mr. Dalvin, you a piece of shit and you got exposed and you mad. What's up with the Houston bottom?
Shout out to Riri, the MVP. No, but
yo, what's up with the Houston bottom?
And you know the funny part about that whole Houston bottom thing is the motherfucker that gave me that tea blocked me. I'm starting to think it was Nicole. It might have been Ellie. You know, these people be coming from pages. You don't know who they is. Track that shit back. It's gonna go back to the motherfucking motherland. It's gonna go back to, what's that, in Antigua?
That's what I'm saying. Never, so many people swear they know. They swear they don't be watching us. That's how they know me.
Oh, Lee Carson was just... Lee Carson was just replying to, on his video, he was just replying to stuff that they were saying, talking about, oh, they were asking, what does Lee Carson do for work? You know, like, I guess being in his business or whatever. And so he starts explaining. He's like, I don't even know why I'm explaining to this. You know, it's I don't even know why it's getting to me. Da, da, da. I'm like, because y'all be in on these T pages. Y'all be watching us. We be watching you. Y'all be watching us. Oh, another thing I told Dalvin and Lee Carson, I said, excuse me, why the fuck is y'all going on these hobo tours on all these T channels? Why don't you just go live on your own page and address some shit? Why do you have to go on
They feel like they bigger than the program. Like, they ain't gonna do it, but they stay in the bushes. So everybody say hi to Snoop, Nicole, and Dalvin right now, because they all in the bushes right now.
So this is another thing. Listen. So I'm over here like, okay, why don't you go live, da 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 da, on Dalvin's latest video? He's like, so I think I'm going to actually do a live. Oh, my God. So now you want to be a T-channel. Child, these motherfuckers get on my motherfucking nerves. Dalvin's finna throw him a tea party, y'all. Because he done seen us grooving and jugging and moving over here. And I think another reason why.
Jugging and moving.
I think another reason why he don't want to. Penelope, you were just so extra. What was so funny about that? Am I really that funny, y'all? Because Penelope just be over exaggerated.
Wait, you say
I be losing my train of thought with this bitch. That bitch said jugging and moving.
Hold on.
Jugging and moving.
Not this man. Answer jugging and moving. Jugging and moving.
No, because this is the thing, you gotta think about it. It's a mind fuck when you're eating for a living on YouTube and making money off it, and there's people that are not eating, making money off of you, just talking about you fucking gagging on fucking hot dogs and shit. Like, these people are not even mukbangers. Mukbangers are people that eat lots of food. These niggas don't. Motherfucking Lee Carson was like, oh yeah, this is gonna last me for like all day. Nigga, it's a mukbang if you don't eat that shit and let that motherfucking belly hang out and unbuckle that buckle and unzip that zipper and let it hang.
And then Nicole be over there talking about, oh, well, I'm just trying to knock out a video.
Girl. And she be hiding her church lady under them big old shirts. She be wearing Daddy Chunk Chunk size. It's like they switch bodies simultaneously. And it's so crazy because this is another thing I want to address. And this is the main point of this motherfucking video. Do y'all think Dalvin lost all that weight from going in the gym? Or do y'all think that nigga lost that weight because of stress? Stress and motherfucking depression. Let's talk about it. That man is not hitting no motherfucking gym.
I know if you guys see me on my Instagram, I post on my story, you see me going hard in the gym. You know, I have a lot of sweat.
Nigga, every time you move, you sweat. Nigga. You go walk down, you go walk a block, and I bet you will be sweating. Because you just one of them people. Some people just sweat easily. Dalvin's one of them, just like he get dizzy easily. Talk about he almost fell. Even in that video, he talk about some guys, I was in the lobby.
And the ground started shaking. The room started spinning. I said, oh no.
I'm really believing that Dalvin is something is mentally wrong with this man. I feel like he will plan in his head, like look around and then fall out on purpose just so people can say, oh my God, what happened? And I feel like he's not even a real solid ass nigga that he will even fall through with the fall. I feel like he'll try to break his own fall. He wouldn't even really like believe and go all the way through with it 100% and just fall out. Like, you know how the gay boys, when they be voguing and they just drop on the ground? He won't even do a death drop. That nigga fucking try to like break his own fall and like land on his thigh or something like that and then hit the ground. You feel me? That man is stressing over Ellie because she knows something. Exactly. That's why. And it's not like, oh, he's stressed out about this lady because she left him. He don't give a fuck. He wanted her to fucking leave. He said it in videos. If I was him, I would have deleted them videos. I'll leave all that shit. I would have deleted every video I ever had with Ellie just to wipe it from everybody's memory so y'all can't go back and say a fuck ass thing. So that is a great segue into this lady's video that I do want to play. But let's read a couple more comments of, you know, because people was tired of his bullshit. So somebody said, they said, it's the pity party for me. That's what Chef Roy said. They said, grab a mirror. Are you better? ? Whom not guilty cast the first stone? Zaddy is fine. Okay, whatever. I don't know what the fuck that bitch is talking about. But he do definitely need to grab a motherfucking mirror, look at himself and ask himself, Zaddy Chunk Chunk, are you better? That nigga, let me tell you something. When you lose weight and you're in the gym, You build, you exchange it for muscle, you get more tone. That nigga looks sunken in. He look like he in a sunken place. Penelope, let me know when you're ready to come back up. Is you here?
Yeah, I'm not trying to, like, don't take this personal, but I gotta go.
Okay, baby.
Yeah, like, I don't, yeah, I'm just, I have to go. I would stay up here, but I can't.
You is being extra.
No, I'm really being serious. I don't really want to get into it. I'll explain at a later time, but I gotta go.
Okay, bye. Okay, so Penelope probably was rewinding the video right now. You know, she likes to rewind the video as we do the motherfucking lives to hear herself talk. Okay, they said, no, that's why I said I don't think people really watch his videos, because they said, what did he do exactly? Because I feel like people are coming up with assumptions and stuff. Watch the video, bitch. That's how I know people do not watch him. They do not watch his video. They watch him say, what is this? And then they turn it off. They like the video and they put a comment, Zaddy Chung Chung, great, great content. Keep it coming. And they literally click off. I bet you his watch hours are very low. Because, you know, like, if your views are low, that's one thing. But your watch hours also, you know, have a big contribution too. And like I said, I didn't start watching him until Ellie. That's what gagged me, because I never knew he was like that. I never knew he was like that, y'all. And then when somebody said, like, stop begging for sympathy, a lot of people in the comments was like, this right fucking here, or this comment right here. Like, they would just own it. Like, they were just like, thank you, somebody said it. He said, and then somebody said, you didn't watch the video because he said he's just not active on social media. He isn't talking about YouTube. Next time, maybe just watch the video or don't comment. I low-key agree with that. But then again, it's like he always clickbait, and everything this man do is clickbait. The only time he didn't clickbait is when he was in a dark space. That's the only time. And it was so bad that he clickbait so much. He has to trick people into watching his video. That speaks volumes, guys. That speaks fucking volumes. Let's get into these comments over here. They said, walking on eggshells. Mommy, please don't tell him. Right. Y'all, like, she... And then when she was on Truth Hurts Her panel, she started crying. Now, I kind of... feel like it was staged a little bit, but I feel like it was a real cry, because she was like, ask me questions, and they weren't really asking her questions. So then she just bust out with the waterworks, like, one day, like, soon as the first question they asked her, well, Ellie, do you think you ever come and say what Zaddy Chung Chung did, or why you guys broke up? And she immediately started crying. And I was just like, I was confused. But then, you know, she said she a crybaby. Dalvin said she a crybaby. She probably was hurt. But this is another thing. It's like, she wanted to be in an open relationship so bad. Go watch the videos when they talked about an open relationship. Dalvin basically said it was her plan, and she didn't deny it. She was all for it. She wanted to be in an open relationship. She wanted to leave the relationship open. So I don't think it necessarily had to do with cheating. I think it had a lot to do with mental and emotional abuse. Think about it. She used to be, Adama would be like, I'll be telling Ellie, like, to get up, let's go. And she'll be sitting on the middle of the closet floor, like, just sitting there. I'm like, because she feels defeated. She just woke up. She's tired. You want her to rush out the house in 20 minutes? She's a girl. You know it take a girl an hour or two to get dressed, and then you feel like she should wake up. Y'all leave the house at 7. You feel like she need to wake up at 5 or 6 to get ready. And then another motherfucking thing is, you're not getting up early in the morning and doing all this extra shit now that she gone. Dalvin the type of motherfucker be like, I need a new charger for my phone. We need to go, wait in the parking lot at Best Buy at 6 and 7 so I can wait until, like, he a weirdo. What would this man have to do all the time every morning? He don't got no job. It's not like they was going to the gym together that earlier running a mile. He did something. He emotionally abused that lady. Or for her to cry like that, I feel like she knew he was zesty. So I don't really feel like it was. But then again, like I said, I put that Houston bottom stuff out there. And that was like, and then around that same time, they stopped talking. Around that same time, they stopped talking. And if you really want to add the shit up, I'm just hypothetically speaking. If you add the shit up, 2 months ago, I dropped my video. 2 months ago, she left. And then for a good 5-6 videos, he was putting out old videos. He was trying to cover something up. Because if they would have just broke up for him cheating, he's a narcissist. He would have been happy to tell us he cheated on Ellie and he fucked up. But how do you cheat on somebody that's so beautiful? Now, Ellie's not the most beautifulest person, but she was beautiful on the inside too. Then he said, we don't know her, so who is Ellie really? She cussed him out of them text messages, showed us the side we never saw. You motherfucking bitch, you're really a bitch. I'm pretty sure she talked like that to him in his face. When you go watch, say, oh, we got in our first argument. How do you feel? Who asks somebody how they feel after their first argument? Bitch, I feel like still whipping your ass. Why is you bringing it up on camera? You really finna piss me off all over again. But I can't talk to you. I was talking to you earlier. So now you're trying to front in front of these motherfucking cameras. But I checked you enough not to play with me on this motherfucking camera. But girl, you know, niggas don't learn. They're going to come back with the same bullshit. Especially a narcissist. They don't learn from shit. They could damn near die and still be a narcissist. Oh, it's so funny because the lady even said, she said the only time she ever seen Dalvin lose his appetite is when he caught COVID. Ellie made that nigga lose his whole appetite. This nigga don't even want to do YouTube no more. And she said she think that because Ellie exposed him from still putting out videos, he was embarrassed. When you see, that's embarrassing, but you could just chop that up to the game. But he's a narcissist, so he felt exposed. So if he felt that exposed by her just giving us a little sip of the tea, just imagine that man was fucking. And then, like I said, I feel like she really didn't say nothing because Ellie, if she exposed that man, she's gonna be liable for that man jumping off a cliff. He gonna jump off that high rise because he's not mentally stable. Like how he tried to say, he sat there and convinced her, stay out the comment sections. If you're not mentally strong and he's mentally strong, this, this, and that, he can handle the comments. He can handle this. He can handle that. Girl, no, he can't. Dalvin, soft as tissue. That man is as soft as a motherfucking Kleenex. Shout out to Nae Bae because she be spitting that real shit. She don't entertain none of that I'm straight narrative that Dalvin be over there pushing, y'all. She be telling the motherfucking truth. And she come with the receipts. She don't even do commentary. She just come with the receipts. Here, look at this. Here we go. This is the lady I want us to react to. Okay, she said, right, like a dog with a shirt on. Damn, I hate that I read the comments so late because I don't even know. clickbait is annoying. Yes, the fuck it is. His dark place was the room with the lights out. That was clickbait to me. Yeah, that was definitely clickbait. Hey, Melissa. Hey, everybody that's in the live. Ellie wanted an outlet or out, rather. Yeah, she did. He's demanding. Yes, he is. He wants to be the head bitch in charge. That's what he really want to be. He want to be like his mama. But there can only be one beloved bitch. Bow down. He always bringing us stuff on camera. He wants the girl to give a full explanation why he stuffed his face. Who wants everything about their relationship on YouTube? Exactly. But then he doesn't say anything like Ellie even said. Like when she tried to talk to him, ask him questions, you know, try to figure him out, help him figure himself out. He has no feedback. This man has no substance, no depth to him. He's a very surface person and he's very shallow. He's very materialistic. He's a material girl. I'm on Shanada Abu. Every time I tell mukbangs, no, I'm the truth. Material girl. And I get it from my mammy. Y'all ain't bust down. These hoes can't stand me. I bet you Dalvin bumps that in his motherfucking car when nobody is around. I bet you. I could bet my life. If God rewind Dalvin life back, that man, there's a clip of that man from the all-seeing eye lens. Dalvin flying down the freeway at 120 miles per hour. Material girl, I want your dad hollows. Move bangers, no, I'm the truth. Material girl, and I get it from my name, Balmain, bust down, do you hoes can't stand me? Material girl. Eat seafood boils, cracking crab legs, but you know I'm the truth. Yeah, okay, let's listen to her. I'm gonna play this video. Let me know if it's too loud or if the audio sounds good. I have it on my speaker. The speaker is back, y'all, so you know. So the first video, she said, wow, Zaddy Chunk Chunk. So I said, what is she talking about? Wow. Ah, thank you, boo. Yes, you're very welcome. I actually like your content. Some people just be entertaining bullshit. And they don't even be that deep. Like this nigga really don't got shit going on. So it's not that hard to make content. And I'm so mad like my TikTok is gone. Cause the reactions I did to that nigga was so funny. Y'all think I'm funny now? Y'all watch me react to his videos. TikTok was so easy. See this, I'm on here. I enjoy being on here for an hour or two, whatever, bitch. It don't matter. But on TikTok, I had 3-minute videos and I literally will only watch 3 minutes worth of Dalvin's content and then I'll turn his shit off. And within 3 to 5 minutes, that man, like I would watch his video. Within 5 minutes, I'll be turning on my TikTok because he did some outrageous, outlandish shit. And there goes my video for TikTok. Boom, I'm at 50K views. I'm at motherfucking 2K views on here. I went from 50K to 2K. Now I'm in this motherfucking sector with all these old ass has-beens. Fuck, I look like getting back to a has-been. Yeah, I said it has been. Hang it up, flat screen. Plasma. Hey, Bodak, asthma. You need a job? This ain't cutting it. Bodak is who you ain't fucking with. But yeah, now I'm in this old ass sector with all these old ass people. It's old people fighting. They always talk about my age. How old are you? Bitch, how old are y'all? Like, what the fuck? And they wasn't asking me how old I was to give me a compliment. They was asking me how old I was because, oh, that's why he act like that. No, bitch, I act like this because of my personality. Bitch. Oh, these motherfucking new T pages. Bitch, I'm not a T page. This is Bodak Rainbow's TV. I am a motherfucking television, bitch. I'm loud, live, and in color, girl. What are you talking about? Ain't no motherfucking T-Page. I don't give a fuck about what these motherfuckers got going on. But if somebody requested, they be like, oh, can you react to this or can you react to that? Cool. But I went from motherfucking 60K, 120K views to motherfucking, that's why Dalvin was gagging. That's why he had to get me up off motherfucking TikTok. He made it his mission to get me off TikTok. Girl, I was exposing him for real. When he was talking about Ellie here and rolling his eyes, I had the camera all up in his motherfucking mud. Just for that clip. Just that. Not the whole, you ain't gotta watch the whole video. You just go to Bodak Rainbow's TV and watch that little part and be like, what the fuck? Why is he talking to her like that? But hey, it's okay. I don't give a fuck, bitch, because I'm still gonna be motherfucking Bodak. TikTok wasn't paying me, but we finna get paid over here. Motherfucking like the video, y'all. Like the video. Now the grind is never stopping, bitch. Now we finna motherfucking grind till it motherfucking never stops, ho. And get to 1,000 subscribers and getting monetized around this bitch. And if y'all feeling generous, Cash App a bitch. I'm finna drop my Cash App. And anything else, I don't give a fuck what it is. It's no pressure. Oh my God, y'all wrote a whole bunch of comments. Hold on. I be talking, y'all. When I be talking, I be looking away from the phone. Okay, so that fool is bumping Disney songs with his gun. I'm fucking dead. Fucking bumping Cap Rock. This is real. This is me. I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be now. Gonna let this light shine on me. Now I found who I am. Singing Demi Lovato and shit. Like an emo boy. You know, he all whitewashed and shit. I can hear him singing that shit. I always been the kind of boy that hid my stomach. So afraid to tell the world who I really am. You see, I had this dream with mukbangs and food. It's time to let it shine. It's time to really grind. It's time to grind. This is real. This is me. I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be now. Gonna let the mukbangs bang on me. Oh, I'm so sorry, y'all. I'm just full. Jeez, that shout out to Brooklyn Fire. Cause she owed me in my motherfucking conversation, popping her motherfucking shit and talking about facts. That nigga bumping Disney Channel. You can get into the future. You can probably find these, like, the extended version of these songs. I bet you this nigga's playing the extended versions of motherfucking songs. This man want to relive his childhood so bad. With his motherfucking pistol locked and loaded. With one hand on the steering wheel. Not one hand on front or one hand on the steering wheel, one hand on the pistol. Banging what? What is Dalvin listening to? You get the best of both worlds. Chill it out, take it slow. Then you rock out the show. That nigga be up in that bitch bumping. Now that Ellie gone, he can watch all the Disney Plus he want. Child. Okay. Okay. I'm dead throwing walkers and wheelchair parties. Yay! That's what they be doing in the sectors. And bitch, I never wanted to be none of their motherfucking friends, and that's why they don't like me. I told them I don't even want your subscribers. Because if I wanted your subscribers, bitch, I'm very strategic when it comes to this motherfucking shit. I didn't want to come to YouTube anyway. I didn't want to risk my YouTube channel for this petty-ass motherfucking bitch-ass, sympathy-ass motherfucking crybaby-ass nigga. I was not trying to bring this shit to my motherfucking YouTube. Because I already know. And YouTube already censored as fuck. TikTok starting to become censored too. I can't, and it's to the point, I can't even post shit. I can't even post shit on TikTok. If I do one video about Dalvin, I don't gotta say it. That shit will be muted. ASAP. ASAPolis. So I didn't really want to come to YouTube and, you know, talk about Dalvin. But hey, we here. I don't mind, but it is what it is, y'all. I'm over here getting me some water, y'all. We finna listen to this video. And I think y'all can hear me loud and clear. I got some headphones, so I hope you guys can hear me loud and clear. You know, we upgrading the equipment slowly but surely, y'all. I got me some headphones, Al. Shout out to the motherfucking headphones. How much was they? $10? Girl, somebody cash at me $10 for their headphones. For the upgraded equipment, child. Support Black business. Okay, so sip, sip. We're gonna sip this tea. We're gonna sip it slow, y'all. Let me read the rest of these comments before we play the video. I know I used to comment on your videos all the time. Really? See? Oh my God. Hey, wasn't it lit over there on TikTok? It was all kind of comments. All kind of comments. People dying laughing at my reaction. Get in bed. Because you're getting on my nerves. Get. Yes. To the point where it's how I do this for... I don't care about how many views I get. I don't give a fuck about old lady gang. Okay, I don't care about nobody in this motherfucking sector. But somebody had commented on my video talking about something. Oh my God, I'm glad I found you over here. I've been looking for you. Oh my God, I miss you on TikTok. Blah, 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 blah. Those are the people I do it for. I'd rather do it for solid people than do it for 100 motherfucking fake people. Or people that's in my bushes that don't want to say nothing. Bitch, why the fuck is you here? We don't want you here. I don't want you here, bitch. We don't need you here, bitch. We don't want you, boo. We don't need you, bitch. Watch the playback, ho. Oh my God, I'm hella comments behind. Y'all's rolling. Y'all's laughing like that. I love Penelope. I can listen to her all day. Yes, her voice is so soothing. And Penelope gets my sense of humor and gets my trash talking and shit. She don't get offended. And I like that about her. And she's so silly. Like in real life, you know how I'm like a diva on here? In real life, I would be so like cuddly with Penelope. I would get on Penelope nerves. Just because she thinks that she can get on mine, bitch, I'm gonna get on yours. But me and Penelope, we have a good time. Like Penelope remind me of the people I really hang out in real life. Like all them old people in the old stack or old lady gang, I don't relate to them. They don't, we don't, what? Hey, Donnell. Bro, okay, yeah, I read that. Laughing, this is real. I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be. That was my motherfucking song, Cap Rock. I remember that motherfucking shit. I'm not mad at Dalvin for watching Disney Plus. Do your motherfucking big one. But nigga, I don't want to find out that you're in your car bumping. Wish I could be part of that world. You know how they had the kids reacting to that? I bet you Dalvin was all geek with the motherfucking kids. Any of them little kids' reaction, that was Dalvin's live reaction in real life. If you was a fly on the motherfucking wall, that nigga was, he's gonna go to theater to see the Little Mermaid, but he gonna have a COVID mask on. We know that shoe by your motherfucking belly. That's why he losing weight now. So we don't identify him in the motherfucking movie going to go see the Little Mermaid. No, he gonna order that shit at home. He ain't going to the theater going to see that shit. If I swear to God, if I go to the theater, because I'm going to the theater, if I see Dalvin, I'm finna point my finger, hold my stomach, and bust out laughing with tears down my eyes with my motherfucking phone in my hand recording Dalvin. If I ever run into that motherfucker, I might just turn my camera on his ass. I'll give him a little bit of respect and not record his ass, but I feel like if he on some fuck shit, rolling his eyes at Dalvin, record that motherfucker. What was it? It's so funny when I just said that because people say that I remind them of Goddamn Zoe. When me and my best friend broke up, she used to watch Goddamn Zoe to replace me. Now you actually ate. What did I eat? What did I eat, girl? My Wi-Fi fucking up. Oh, hell no. No, not the Wi-Fi. Swinging with a chicken wing on a hand and spitting. Singing with a chicken wing. All right. Killing that shit. How did you remember these songs? Listen, that's my childhood, y'all. Like, I watch Disney Channel. Like, it's no shade to Dalvin watching Disney Plus. Like, I don't knock Dalvin for half the shit he do. I just knock Dalvin for the way he treat people. So, therefore, these are the things I'm going to use to read your ass. I am a reader, y'all. I am the librarian. I'm going to read you for any and everything. If he would have been a regular person and been respectful to women and respectful in general, like I don't think Dalvin's a bad person. He's a big teddy bear, for real, for real. But he like Ted, the teddy bear. He not like a cuddly teddy bear. He like, you know, the Ted teddy bear. But the Ted teddy bear in that movie, he was cool. He was like legit, like, Dalvin just need to hit the blunt. I promise you, that nigga will be straight. I promise you, Dalvin, I used to be a little crazy like that too. You know, nigga, hit the blunt. I'm trying to tell you, bro. I will smoke with you. Or you see, I'm smoking CBD now. Like, I'm smoking CBD for the simple fact that it's like medication to me. Like, I don't even need the motherfucking weed to get high. I just need the weed to make me chill, you know, live in the moment. And the way I'm acting now is how I act on weed, except for I'll probably be more funnier and motherfucking all over the place. I could focus a little more with the CBD and everything. How did you remember these songs? That's funny. Oh, Lady Gang Girl, stop. So my IG is Bodak Rainbows with two Z's. Baby, find me at Bodak Rainbows. I try to keep everything Bodak Rainbows so y'all don't have a hard time finding me. His ass stay in the movie theaters, though. Exactly. Like, bitch, you should just work here since you're just tired of doing YouTube, bitch. And he is tired of doing YouTube. When you say you tired of, so you can't do social media no more and you don't post that much, you don't post because you tired of looking at your fat ass face. That's sinking in because you stressed the fuck out. Okay, but we're not gonna do too much, okay? Because mental health is real, guys. Mental health awareness. You read in 2020 while the old lady gang got thick ass
got thick ass mic vocals. Exactly. They be trying to read.
They be trying to read with the motherfucking bifocals, bitch. My eye vision is good, bitch. I'm the motherfucking librarian. Shut the fuck up. I done told them hoes to shut the fuck up. They done kicked me off their panel. Bitch, I'm the librarian. That's my job is to tell you bitches to shut the fuck up. Okay? And read you bitches to the motherfucking ground. Read you bitches like newspaper, bitch. Okay, tell me if the video is too loud, y'all, because I don't want it to be like distorted, the sound. But this lady was speaking facts, and I like it was coming from a genuine place. Her name is Tanika For Real. Do y'all know who Tanika For Real is?
What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Tanika For Real. I'm back again up in this thing, and I'm doing a reaction video to, not really a reaction, because I'm not going to play the video or nothing like that. Y'all, I ain't really that professional like that to be doing a reaction and stuff like that. I shouldn't be like that. Even though I've been YouTube for a while, but I still not do all that. So I'm good. But anyway, I'm just going to talk about it. So you guys read what the title says. I'm talking about the Zaddy Chunk Chunk situation with Ellie Soul and stuff like that. But anyways, so y'all know I be dipping and dabbing. I be in and out. I play hopscotch for YouTube. I'm in, I'm out. It's not always good. I'm not very consistent. But for the most part, guys, I ain't going to promise y'all that I'm going to be consistent. Because every time I tell y'all, I always end up having something come up or whatever. I'm trying, y'all. I'm trying my best. So.
Girl, we didn't ask for no motherfucking commercial, but shout out to being monetized, child. Bitch, I don't give a fuck if YouTube pay me $200 a month, bitch. That's gonna cover a bill around this motherfucker. We finna do this shit, bitch. We almost at 1,000 views, y'all. And can y'all put in the comment section, I have not done my research, what all do I need to be monetized? We gotta get this shit cracking.
You know, but no matter what, I will say this. I do watch YouTube consistently. And I'm always up on the YouTube streets. You know what I mean? And when I say YouTube streets, it's just like, it ain't the YouTube streets no more. It's almost like the YouTube soap operas. You know, like back in the day when your mom and your grandmother them used to be watching Guiding Lights, The Young and the Restless, All My Children, at around 11, 12 o'clock, after they cook their little dinner, that's what it's called, their little dinner. They, you know, and that's what it is, man. These YouTube streets is cutting up. I'm going to tell y'all what the problem is. They put too much of their damn business on these streets. And they need to, like, you need to keep it off the streets. Then they got mad. They got, I ain't going to say mad. They got nerves to get mad whenever people come and comment down below and say, oh, you this, you that, oh, you wrong for this, you wrong. Then they want to come and make another video trying to clean it up. There ain't no cleaning nothing up. People seeing what you did. People seeing what you posted. Ain't nothing to clean up. Oh, girl. Like Cardi B said, y'all know I always try to get my like Cardi B voice, so I still can't get that voice. And I've been vlogging for almost like 2 years? Anyway, I'm gonna get it one day. Anyway, y'all, let's get right up into this video. So anyway, because y'all know I keep it short, sweet, and snappy. And y'all know I take my notes. So I got notes because you know why I got notes? Because I don't even want to forget about nothing. Not nothing. So anyway, I saw a video, you know, Zaddy Chung Chung did. And I've been watching Zaddy and Elliot's videos and stuff like that for like a good minute now. Basically the whole time they probably been together. I keep up with their videos. I don't watch their whole videos because he likes his videos to be like an hour long and stuff like that. I'm a type of person where if I'm a dip and dab, I'm a dip and dab. I'm going to dip in, dip out. Dip in, dip out. Dip in. I'm just playing, y'all. But I really do. I dip in and I dip out. I'm not about to watch no 56-minute video just for you to get to what your title say. I'm not doing it. I'm trying to fast forward until you get to your point. You know?
And that's another thing. He clickbait, so it's people don't want to watch, like, after you clickbait somebody for so long, they're not going to watch your whole entire video. They're going to skim through that shit.
A lot of y'all probably do that. I ain't the only one. Y'all know I ain't the only one. Don't do that. So anyway, so basically, I'm just saying, I watched this last video that they made. I don't know if it was the last one. It was the last one I saw. And it said, we need space. Now, prior to this video, I had been noticing, like, the way Zaddy move. And I don't know if it was just me, but he got some kind of issues with himself. Controlling issues, which I saw with Nicole. Nicole, of course. But she told him, Yeah, okay, well, sure. Yeah, he's airheaded, whatever. Once again, you know, I'm not trying to judge nobody or nothing. I'm just saying, I'm not, you know, just saying she's so, like, goofy. I call her goofy. To where it's just like, yeah, all right. But then when he got with Ellie, it was kind of like, at first, I kind of felt Nicole vibes from Ellie. But Ellie started showing us a different part of her. You know, Ellie is very beautiful. She's intelligent. She's very, very, very sweet, genuine. And I can tell you, out of all the YouTube channels I have watched, I've never heard anybody say nothing less of Ellie. You know, she's very sweet and genuine. And that's when I saw her do a video with Beloved. That girl was still herself. Like, she was not intimidated by Beloved. She was just herself. And Beloved was asking her questions. I guess I'm not going to say trying to get her intimidated, but she didn't fall for the okie doke. Okay? So, that's what I read. So, anyway, I'm just going to say this video, we need some space. Okay, so I'm going to just hit straight to the point. The whole situation looked like it's caught up because Zaddy Chung Chung apparently went out with his friends one night and didn't wake up Ellie. So he just decided, like, oh, well, you know, I'm kicking it with my friends. I don't know what time in the morning it was, but obviously it was some type of time in the morning because she was in a deep sleep, from what he said. And he decided, I'm just going to get dressed and do all this and do all that and get ready and spray my cologne on and just get out the door and whatever and go with my boys. And so he was like, Ellie had a problem with it. So Ellie was like, well, yeah, you know, I mean, what if something would happen? And what if something would happen? Hell, you don't went out with your friends. Anything could happen. Just so say you go out with your friends, y'all get into a bad car accident, which I would never put that on nobody. You know, I'm just saying, what if? It's a lot of what ifs. You know, and then she get the phone call. Oh, well, yeah, we're just like, you know, that Zaddy's been involved with that. You know, and I'm thinking, last I knew, you was in the bed behind me, right? So she right for it. You know, and he's like, she's asking me all these questions. She wants to know everything about me. Like, she wants to know my whereabouts, who I'm with. Well, I don't blame that girl, Zaddy. That's all a part of having a damn relationship, okay? Get with it. At least with a woman. Because for a long time, I ain't gonna lie. I thought, I'm just saying.
Y'all, definitely with a woman. Because with a man, if you with another nigga, he probably ain't gonna be tripping. Niggas is real laid back, real chill. They ain't worried about too much. But if you with a woman is very, you know, protective, nurturing, cares about your whereabouts. You know what I'm saying? That's why I'm kind of confused, like, was he missing that from his mother? Because I feel like I don't know. But it's so funny because I was watching this old lady and she was like saying, you know how preachers be like, ha ha, ha, when they be talking. And she was like singing like, Daddy Chung Chung. He over there getting, sneaking out in the wee hours of the night. And I'm trying to tell you, she was serious. She wasn't like, that was a part of her commentary. That was who she is. She started singing and humming. I said, oh my God, no, this lady did not take us to church gossiping. She's talking about something, and I think he liked that. And they saying that Daddy Chung Chung might be a. I was dying. I said, no, this lady did not take me to church. But yeah, so everybody, and that's crazy because it's just like everybody can't be saying the same fucking lie. Ain't nobody lying on you. But the only motherfucker you care about speaking on it is Ellie because. You know.
The sugar in your tank. I really thought so. Maybe it was just me.
See?
She but when even you got with Ellie, you proved us wrong. And then y'all come out with the whole open relationship thing. So I was like, well, that's about right. Because, you know, he do his thing. And as far as the way I thought about you. And I'm like, well, maybe. You know, there's a lot of women out there that's open to this. Men are not more open to saying their sexuality like women are.
You know what? And this is why I liked her, because she's older, but she ain't a part of old lady gang. Like, she understand. Like, I feel like some people can be old in spirit and the world can, like, jade you and, like, weather you down. You know what I'm saying? To where you might not have that youth in you spiritually. But I can tell that this lady is still tuned in, because when she said, you know, I thought you had a little sugar in your tank, but you proved me wrong when you brought Ellie. So, you know, we all gave you another chance, basically, to prove that you like women. Then when y'all came with the open relationship, we was like, that kind of makes sense, because Dalvin is a little, you know, but he might be bi. So because she knows his tea, you know, she might be like, oh, well, I'm, you know, I like girls too. So it's cool. Like, we could be in an open relationship, you know, meet in the middle. But do I, you know, date? I'm going to date my girls on the side. You're going to date your boys on the side. And then, you know, hell, we keep that shit separate, or we could bring this shit together and be a whole big-ass happy family. Because they talked about all those type of things in those, in the open relationship. That's when, and I think when they got the, when the mom started making the video, you know, Dalvin got scared. You know, he don't want his mom. That's the main thing. People don't be wanting their parents to know. They don't really be caring. I've never seen Dalvin as a down low man. I seen him as being discreet. If you're in the gay community, you would know that the word discreet means you're just, you keep your business on the low. You know what I'm saying? Not the down low, but just on the, you know, where you just don't be telling people. People assume, but you would throw out like little things out there to make yourself seem masculine. That's why that whole dominant thing throws me off, because I don't think that it's a submissive and dominant thing. If you asking for a bottom, just say that. That's what a bottom is, a submissive man that wants to bend over and take that hook. Hey! But, you know, if that's what you're asking for, but a woman can't, a vagina can't be no more submissive. A vagina opens up and says, hello, welcome to Coochie Land. You know, with a back door, you got to kind of, you know, do some forced entry in that motherfucker. That's why me personally, I don't deal with the back door, because I don't want to feel like I'm taking your shit. And every time I do it, I feel like I'm squeezing something in a tight place that it don't need to be going over there. So I don't use my stuff for stuff like that. I let others use their stuff, because I'm going to throw this ass back regardless. Okay? But I hope y'all get my drift. So with that being said, I have had sex with women. When you fuck a woman, it's not like you forcing nothing. You know? It just, you slide in, it get wet, it welcomes you with open arms. It's, you know, it feels like a million fucking hands greeting your penis, head, and all everything else. Shit, you damn near want to throw your balls in there too. Shit. But that's neither here nor there. That's just me. You get a different appreciation for a woman when she gives you her vagina. It's like, dang, she beautiful. That's how niggas be getting caught. Oh, I'm in love. When you get pussy with. But I'm trying to tell you, Bodak can't be pussy with, because I'm not naturally attracted to women like that. I'm sexually attracted No, I'm sorry. I'm not sexually attracted. I'm physically attracted, but I'm not sexually attracted. Like women, you know, ain't, I can't be pussy with. But men can get pussy with, if you know, whatever, whatever. So that's what I'm saying. Like he wasn't, she was beautiful. You know what I'm saying? Like, sir, what was it about Ellie that we need you? I believe that there's two sides of the story, then there's the truth. And the truth is Bodak. Okay.
So, you know, Ellie came out basically said, yeah, you know, I draw women, you know, I like art, you know, naked women to be exact and stuff like that. And then, you know, I like women, I like men, you know, Zaddy wasn't really saying what his sexuality was. Okay. So anyways, getting back to the story, he left out the house. Oh, 3-4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, he wasn't really speaking on nothing. That's another thing. That's why I said he's discreet. It's more of a don't ask, don't tell kind of method. But another thing is when she was talking about, you know, her, the girl, I feel like Ellie, that's what she really wanted to do. She wanted to have a man and two niggas. That's what I think. Or she wanted to have a girl on the side and have Dalvin. Ellie wanted to have her cake and eat it too. Dalvin's selfish just as a person. So he like, girl, you're not going to be having all the fun and I be in the house. Bored. If I got to be bored, you got to be bored too. That's what I think would happen in their relationship. And it just kind of turned into something that it wasn't supposed to be because of jealousy. Dalvin was jealous of Ellie, y'all. And Ellie was trying to, she was being a people pleaser. She was trying to please him for some agenda and maybe got her feelings hurt in the process and threatened to hurt his feelings back. You know, it's like when friends break up. I don't feel like it was like when you break up with your man. I feel like it was when you break up with your friend. You know, when you break up with your man, that's a different type of breakup when you break up with your friend. It could still be just as, you know, emotional. But anyways, he wasn't saying nothing about his sexuality. But when Ellie was talking about how the guy got two boyfriends and stuff, he was just cheesing from ear to ear. Talking about, really? That's hectic. I don't know. Really? He was contemplating, girl. He was curious about the open relationship thing. And Ellie was pitching it to him like she was a salesman. Ellie got the gift of gab, baby. I was watching her. Okay?
I would be upset too. Y'all comment down below if y'all man got up and left at that time in the morning when you in a deep sleep. I don't care if it's 9, 10 o'clock at night. If I'm in a deep sleep and your ass is leaving out the house, let me know. Because I got OCD. I won't check my door. I don't care if you locked it. I want to go press on the knob and make sure it's locked. Okay? So, let's get to the notes. So, his little negative attitude on his video, y'all. If y'all go back and we all watch that video, we need some space. The whole video, he was just really being rude. He got straight to the point. Like, normally, when people do a video, they really, like, they drag on. Then they get to the point. So he said some stuff along the lines to where, yeah, by the way, I'm sick of you giving people these false narratives about me. What you mean, I'm sick of?
That is ugly. Bro, when that lady said that, I love a mature woman. I'm talking about, like, when you know how these people want to be old so motherfucking bad. It ain't about your age. I just love a woman that's in her age and know what the fuck she's talking about and stands on what the fuck she's talking about. And when she said sick of, she stopped at the sick of. Fuck the narrative. That's how my brain works. Because men are very logical. Women are emotional. But we all got a brain. You feel me? So logically, I just, like, that's where I used to stop at with Dalvin. Like, who is he talking to? Like, I used to be rooting for Ellie to check him. Like, bitch. Like, if Dalvin had, I promise you, because there's podcasts out there that bash women and have these, like, narratives about women. Like, I don't know if you guys heard of it. I don't know the name of the podcast. But if Dalvin had, like, majority men supporters, oh, he would be killing it right now. He would be doing his motherfucking thing. And it's not, I think that he would be able to get away with the shit he does. And I think he probably would be more out there with it too. I think he probably does. You think he's doing something right now? I think he'll be doing more shit if his channel was mainly men. But because it's so many women, you have people kind of give him the side eye by the things he do and stuff like that, because you have to go with your demographic or cater to your demographic. But anyways, she killed me on that part where she said, getting sick of. Like, that part what got me, that's when I started getting into the video. So this is where it's going to get juicy, because, baby, she's going to talk about the facts, okay? And over here with Bodak in the Rainbow Kingdom, that's what, like, that's what we like to deal with, the facts.
To where? Yeah, by the way, I'm sick of you giving people these false narratives about me. What you mean I'm sick of? That was ugly and rude. I feel like he could have put that another way. And then saying I'm sick of people, you giving people these false narratives. I feel like this here.
Bitch, you giving like the false narratives.
I don't say force it because she's a woman. She's grown. She can do what she want to do. But I feel like he really like kind of coerced her to be into this YouTube environment, as along a lot of YouTubers.
And see, she's smart. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to see that Dalvin forced her to be on camera. He literally walked in on while she was sick, down and out, and recorded her on camera without her consent. Okay? Not only is he filming her without her consent, he has cameras all around the house watching Ellie. Okay? Do y'all understand the control? The government is doing shit like this. Putting fucking cameras on drones and watching us through fucking robot pigeons and robot roaches and shit. If Dalvin can have a robot roach, he'd be flying this motherfucker all around Houston. And people, and just being nosy. That's just pure nosiness. How be less than, yeah, Dalvin's very rare, his surrounding. He's always been like that. Very keen when it comes to his, no, he's just nosy as fuck. I hate how people try to disguise as being nosy. Me personally, I be hating on nosy people because I be wanting to be nosy so bad. I'm just not good at it. If I can't see it, I can't tell you what the fuck going on. I can't ear hustle for shit. I could read a little bit of lips. But when people be hearing shit, I be like, how the fuck you hear that? And I be listening hard. I don't try to listen so hard. I cannot make out not a fucking word. I hate that I can't ear hustle. Dalvin is nosy. That's it. That's all. Ain't nothing cute about it. To the point where he putting cameras all around the motherfucking house. And then you already had in your mind that you was going to bring Ellie on this camera because she was pretty. But then when you saw your views go up and saw the love she was getting, you like, damn, they really like her. Because he's a narcissist. I had a friend who was I had to end that friendship after 12 years completely, because it's like, no matter what I do, you're always going to be a narcissist to the day you freaking die. There's no cure to narcissism. There's only treatment. I don't think y'all heard me. Let me say it one more time for the bitches in the back. There's no cure for narcissism. Only treatment. Dalvin's not going to change. So there he goes, painting these narratives. He's talking about he's sick and tired of her painting narratives. Bitch, you're motherfucking Picasso around this motherfucker. You're the painter. You're painting the motherfucking narratives. You're painting them now. Ellie exposed you for painting narratives. Acting like y'all was still in the ghetto. You've been painting this narrative that you like women for a very long time. And you got exposed by who? Bodak, the motherfucking fairy king. Bitch, I came with my motherfucking wand instead. Ding! Just like how Tinkerbell do on Disney Plus when she hit that, when she make that motherfucking mouth before the TV show come on and she say, ding! With her little wings, with the pixie dust. Bitch, that was Bodak. On your motherfucking ass, bitch.
They get with women, single men all the time. They get with these women, and what the first thing they want to do, put them on their page. Put the women on their page to try to make their views go up so they can have more content. You know, because by yourself, it's really nothing to talk about when you're by yourself, when you're a YouTuber. Honestly, you got somebody by your side, you got somebody talking for you. Another thing I don't like, you know, they do a video together. And this girl could talk, and this girl, you know, she's going along with him and everything else. The minute he run out of words and ain't got shit to say, first thing he tell her, What's wrong, Ellie? You're kind of quiet.
The fact that somebody else is seeing this. Mind you, when I was on TikTok, soon as that nigga would do shit like that, I'd turn my camera on. As soon as he said, I said, what the fuck is you talking about? And that would be my reaction. And people would be like, thank God somebody's saying the shit. So that's how I feel in this moment, that I'm looking at somebody that actually took the notes and said, you know what, nigga, this is where you're wrong at. And I'm not talking shit about you. I have nothing against you. I'm pointing out things that you need to change. You need to learn how to talk to people. I understand B-Love is the head bitch in charge and she the motherfucking queen bee. The queen crab. The king queen crab. Okay? She wear the jeans and the motherfucking dress in her motherfucking house. But she paid her dues. She can do that. You're not your mom. That's why your plate doesn't look like hers. Okay? That's why your views don't look like hers. That's why your subscribers don't look like hers. She paid her motherfucking dues. She got it out the motherfucking mud. She grinded and never stopped so that you can have a platform. Now check that.
What's wrong? You don't have anything to say? First of all, this is your video. This is not Ellie's video. Ellie don't have to fill in them cracks for your ass. I mean, you be loved, son, and all that, but your mama don't even act like that. You know, and one thing I respect about B-Love is she's not arrogant. You know, what we see from her, that you never see B-Love bragging. This girl didn't collab with celebrities. This girl didn't, you know, she done built herself from the ground up, but you don't see her act like that. I understand it's one thing about ambition, but it's another thing about arrogance. You know, and you kind of like, you thin line right now, you know?
Yes, it is a motherfucking thin line when it comes to disrespect and respect. It's either one or the other. Okay? That man was very disrespectful to Ellie. Who the fuck is you checking on this camera to all these motherfucking people you finna post this video to talking about I ain't talking? And the whole thing about it is she be talking. That motherfucker sat there. It's so funny how he do it too. I wish y'all could see me because I be impersonating too. That motherfucker be sucking on that chicken bone and then roll his eyes at her and then be nibbling on it, looking at her and be like, Ellie,
why aren't you saying anything?
Like, this motherfucker is creepy. Like, you're watching me? Like, he was micromanaging her. Have you ever been micromanaged at work, guys? Have you ever been micromanaged at work? It makes your skin crawl. It makes you want to fight. You be ready to beat a bitch up. Especially if you watched Bad Girls Club that previous night. Oh, you ready to go to fuck home. You ready to clock out and say fuck all this shit. Don't micromanage me. Girl, like that shit, like right now I'm having flashbacks. I'm getting mad. And I really want to fight right now. That's why it was just with Ellie. I was like, girl, it's only a matter of time before I'm finna say, bitch, fuck you and feed you to that motherfucking grizzly bear. Because, bitch, ain't no way you letting this shit fly. In one video, he told her, what she said? He said, the first thing he said, damn, I forgot what she just said. He said, oh, he was rude to her. Girl, I don't know. Let me play the video.
So, like I said, y'all comment down below. When I look down, I'm looking at my notes. Because y'all know I take my notes. So, another thing I didn't get with. He actually told her when she had a problem with the fact he was leaving out the house and going with his friends. He made the comment, well, maybe you need to find some friends. And she's like, well, you know, and there's a lot of people like that. Because I'm like that too. You know, I'm a lonely loner. I don't need friends.
First of all, let me just say this, you know, just to make it clear. Ellie found her a friend. The first friend she found in them apartments complex, he said, Ellie made a new friend, guys. Telling all her business, throwing it out there. Yeah, Ellie made a new friend. She's been downstairs at the pool for hours talking. Well, actually,
She's our friend, isn't she?
Ellie's like, no, I think she's my friend.
Wait, she's my friend too. Why wouldn't she be my friend?
I could not believe this man did that cornball shit. He's trying to throw himself at, oh, that's my friend too. First of all, you don't even know the bitch to even call her your friend. And then when your homegirl get friends, that don't make them that your friends. Dalvin wants to be one of the homegirls. Usually when a bitch have a man and your friend come by, that's not your man friend either. That's your friend. You keep your man and your friend separate. That's etiquette. That's relationship etiquette. Girl, you introduced them. Cordial. Dalvin want to be down there at the pool too. I bet you he walked his big belly ass. His belly walked him to the pool to go check on her because he likes to micromanage. He stayed there for a little bit. He gave her the cue. Come on, let's go upstairs. She ignored him. And he walked in. He got tired because he wanted to go watch Disney Plus. He went back upstairs, watched Disney Plus, and watched her from the window. When the commercials came on, he would look at the window. She's still there. The motherfucking watcher. That's creepy. Dalvin gives me creepy vibes. That's why I call him Dalvin Dahmer. Like, I feel like he's a weirdo. Like, on a different kind of level. Like, on some, like, fuck the gay shit. That didn't, like, I'm beyond that. I feel like that nigga could put a fucking camera in the toilet. He would put one just to see what you ate today. Just want to see if you ate all the fruit snacks. So he gonna put a fucking camera in the toilet so he could see what the fuck coming out your ass.
I feel like as long as I got you, I'm good. You know, and it's not always good to be like that, but I'm just not a friendly person. And there's a lot of people that's not friendly. First of all, she don't even live down there in Houston. She's a native of New York. I'm not gonna say native, but she's...
Well, tell your mama to listen to this. Dad would be like, Ally.
I gotta say it two times, because it just don't sound right if I say it once.
Ally. Did you eat all the fruit snacks? And I got you sparkling water. Why are you drinking my Capri Suns? There's 12 that come in the pack of the Capri Suns. I only have 11. I didn't even open them. So you mean to tell me you drunk the first Capri Sun?
Dalvin, I only took 3 sips of the Capri Sun and it was gone. Like, it's not that big of a deal. I just needed to quench my thirst. I just got back from the gym with my friend.
You mean our friend? Wait, what friend? Our friend or your friend?
Our friend, Dalvin.
Oh, I thought you were talking about somebody else. Okay, continue. Why were you drinking the Capri? I like to have my Capri Suns when I have my popcorn and my nachos, when I watch Disney Plus. Tonight, we're going to be watching Lilo and Stitch. I need you to be here on time. Tell that friend, our friend, goodbye at the pool. You're getting all dark, Ellie. You've been outside all day. You're getting a tan. You're getting blacker than me. Your hair's getting dry, Ellie. Your hair's getting dry. Your lips are getting chapped. You don't want to come inside? It's pretty hot out there. Well, take the camera with you and vlog. Why don't you vlog being outside by the pool and you vlog your conversation and post it on your channel, Ellie Belly?
From New York. Once
Why did that man? He making you.
But she's from New York, so she left her true friends down there in New York. She come out here. She doing this for you. And now all of a sudden you want to get a little, you know, jig in your body. So what, you want to go and you want to go to your friends. Then you want to wonder why she ain't got no friends. You been no shit had no friends before you did this. So what is you doing? That's one red flag right there, Ellie. You know, I'm so glad Ellie left. I'm not going to lie.
And then another thing is he differentiates. See, me, I pay attention to details because I talk to a lot of down low men, so I know exactly what I'm looking for when I talk to them to know if they get down or not. 9 out of 10, if I get out a man, I get him because he said or done something that I picked up on. Another thing that Dalvin does,
he differentiates the men from women when he talks about his friends. He'd be like, yeah, you know, today, guys, I'm going to, I went to go hang out with my friends. And, no, he'd be like, you know, I go to the bar and stuff when I have time, but I'm a social drinker. I don't want no one to think, let's stop this narrative that I'm an alcoholic. I don't be in the comments. I don't be in the bushes, guys, but I definitely be in the bushes because I don't know that you guys are talking about me, but I do for some odd reason. It's like I'm having these premonitions of the comment section, but yeah. I go to the comments and you guys are creating narratives that I'm an alcoholic. I'm a social drinker. You know, I drink with my friends or my homies. What's the difference between a friend and a homie? My friends and my homies. Okay, women and men? Aren't they? Wouldn't they just all be classified as under the friends? Is friends too, like, I don't get it. My homies. He likes having homies. His guys, his boys. Like, what the fuck? Niggas like that, they be like, my niggas and my niggas. Like, they sound like the bitches that I be fucking hanging out with. I wish I could bring her. She just texted me. I should go tell her because she be wanting to come on my YouTube channel. Tell her, like, girl, when I was talking with you today, what did you talk about my nigga? Because, you know, my nigga this, you know, my nigga don't play that because my nigga. Some of these niggas be sounding like bitches. Yeah, because my nigga, that my motherfucking nigga. That's how Dalvin be saying, because, you know, my homies, Nair and Lee Carson. Like, boy, shut the fuck up. And then, for you, but for her to not have friends and you to have these motherfucking friends that just like to hang out at 3 a.m., they only like to hang out after hours. This lady ain't seen you hang out with one person. You been micromanaging her and fucking trying to ride her coattails and be friends with all her motherfucking friends. Now all of a sudden you disappear at night and you got this imaginary friend. Who, Casper? And then when Ellie left, you been sad. You none of your friends care. We ain't seen Lee Carson. We ain't seen Nair. We ain't seen Nair in a year. The fuck?
If y'all watch that video, Ellie looked real irritated. Like she was just putting up with the shit, as she do on a lot of their videos. Like a lot of things he say is so like disrespectful. Like almost like he want his videos to be so perfect. So where you on my video, you gotta do this. It's the way you serve. For example, you know, I noticed this on the video. Y'all go back and watch that video. I'll tell you no lie. This girl was wiping crumbs off of her. Like if I lean down, y'all, and I, like, lean my head down, he basically was like, I can't quote his exact words, but he was basically like, stop looking down. What you doing? Ain't nothing down there. You know, look up. And Ellie always so sweet. Sweet little Ellie. Okay. In another instance, when they were laughing, he said something. And Ellie laughed. You know how you laugh and you lean on somebody? She leaned on him. He looked at his shirt as if her head had gave him monkeypox or some shit. And then he had the nerve to say, why would you lean on my head, on my shoulder like that?
When he- That's some shit I'll tell Penelope. And Penelope laid her motherfucking head on me. Girl, what a... I'm gonna dust my shoulder like, girl, not too fucking much, bitch. That's how Dalvin act. Dalvin act like me. But honestly, I really don't treat women like that. Like, I love women. But that's why, you know, I stick up for them so, and go so hard, you know, especially for Ellie. But it's just like, wait. This lady leaned on you, tried to, like, she be trying in them videos. He says she don't talk too much. She be confused as fuck when he say that, but she was just trying to talk more. I see all the effort. It's like, I used to say, call her damn that she do, damn that she don't. If she do something, she doing too much. If she don't do something, she ain't doing enough. What the fuck do you want her to do? What you want her to do? You want her to peg you? Do y'all know what pegging is? Who knows what pegging is? Do you want this lady to peg you? I think that's what she needs to do. I think she needs to peg you so you understand that you're the submissive. Nagging is a bitch trait. That's not manly. It's a fucking turnoff. Any female that opens her legs to a man like that? Come on now, Ellie. You can understand why I'm giving you the side eye, because even women that are attracted to gay men, that are okay with men having a sexuality, what you call it? Y'all, I done forgot. Whatever, they open to, you know, whatever. Y'all know what the fuck I'm trying to say. There's plenty of attractive gay. Have y'all ever seen a gay man be like, damn, he gay? Damn. Ellie, if you want a gay man, there's plenty fine bisexual men in the world. Why the fuck? Girl, you for you to open your legs to that girl and then be led to say, is you still on birth control? So you was letting him hit it raw? I am disgusted. Like, I was looking at Ellie disgusted. Let's be real. Like how she jumped on, what's her name, panel? She needs to be clicking my motherfucking link and explaining to me why the fuck she opened her legs to him. What did he do that made you feel like you wanted to open your legs? I want to know, because when you lean your head on him, he look at you like you got shit on your motherfucking forehead. When you touch him, he look at you like you got cooties. He don't even want to kiss you. So, why? I can't believe he even made it to between your legs. Well, you guys don't know everything of what happens off camera. Girl, with the shit we see on camera, I could just imagine what happens off camera. If he is messing around with you sexually, shit. I don't know how. Is you pegging him? That's what I want to know. Child.
And all those products in your hair. Why would you? Ooh, boy, I was just about to say something, but you two weren't going to agree with it. You better be lucky you had Ellie. And not me. I'm going to stop right now. I just feel like he's too controlling. From the video, if you watch the video, he's basically telling her, okay, they got this amount of food. They got cheese, fries, they got chicken wings, and they got some gyros in the back. And Ellie starts picking in the cheese fries. He get mad. Why are you picking all the cheese off the top, the fries off the top, go on the bottom and dip? Like, damn, boy, you can lose weight. You don't need all that cheese anyway. The hell? You worry about if that girl pick off the top or the damn bottom. Ellie ain't gonna eat all that shit. She just gonna get some. Every video you wanna eat, dip and dab in her food, Ellie never say nothing. But then when it come to your food, then at one point in the video, he like, I'm just about to take these for myself. These are for me. Man, share that food, man. Share that food. You might lose some weight. Share that food. That's just me talking. I'm just saying. I can't get with the arrogance. I can't. You know, it's almost like if he act like that with that girl on camera, I can almost imagine what she goes through behind cameras. And
that's another thing. When her parents and people of her family was watching that, even her little nephews and stuff like that, like, you know, you have a family channel. This lady has her, she even said her little cousin watches it. How do you think her little cousin feels? Kids are the most innocent and the most real. You think her little cousin doesn't see how you treat his favorite auntie or her, you know, like, you get what I'm saying? You think the mother doesn't see how you're treating her daughter, and then you're trying to say, did you tell him it was just content? Like, that's now you're insulting my intelligence. I promise y'all, that's my pet peeve. That'll make me fight somebody. If you ever want to fight Bodak, insult my intelligence, like on some slick shit, like how he did.
Did you tell him it was just content?
Did you tell him to stay out of the comment section? What the fuck is you talking about?
At one point, you know, I don't understand this because everybody's seen the video Ellie made. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. I go on Ellie page, the video is deleted. I can guarantee you. He don't like his business out. He want to be a perfectionist.
Yeah, and he don't like his business out. And she was under the impression that Ellie took the video down, but kind of find out Dalvin took the video down. Child, that's when she was finna expose his ass, because he thought, if he don't want Ellie talking, saying, ooh, girl. Anyways.
He want everything to be Zaddy Chong Chong. How you say it in this video, y'all? The
gang,
the hustle don't stop. The gang don't stop, whatever.
Bitch, I fucking died last night when she said that shit, because I was wondering what she finna say.
Hello? I had to get on my other phone. I was charging my phone this whole fucking time, but the motherfucking, I guess that I was actually on the device, it didn't charge. I don't fucking know. I'm gonna start streaming on my Android, because iPhone, girl, they be playing. I'm so sorry. We was just getting into some shit. What the fuck? And it's so funny, we had 29 views, bitch, everybody left. They said, fuck this shit. I'm finna go across the street real quick. You motherfucking fake bitches. No, I'm just playing. We can't even hear what the rest of the shit the bitch was saying. But shout out to her, Tamika, because she really was like confused and trying to make the shit make sense. Really was trying to make the shit make sense. She's like, he's rude. The way he talks to her. Y'all, I'm in shock that my motherfucking phone. Can you come back, buddy? Can y'all hear me? Can y'all hear me? Let me know if y'all can hear me. Every time my light go down, we just gonna blame him. Like he COVID. Good commentary, I'm enjoying it. Thank you. Okay, cool. Y'all, the motherfucking phone is fucking up my little thing, my little groove. But does anybody want to come up and talk? Anybody? Because the fucking phone died. I do want to stay on so we can listen to like the rest of her video. It's really, really good. But this motherfucking dumb ass phone. Why would it die and it was on the charger? It messed up my motherfucking group. Okay. But even if I turn it on right now, it's still gonna, you know what? That just pissed me off. I don't even do this shit no more. But yeah, we got to the point of what I was trying to get at. Her video, y'all go check out Tamika. This is old shit, but he's boring, y'all. We ain't got shit to talk about when it comes to him. Is there any suggestions that y'all want to see me do commentary to? Like I said, we're going to get to the point where y'all will see me on camera and I'll be reacting live to videos. I think about doing Real Housewives of Atlanta reviews. Like, I like doing shit like that, y'all. I like having an opinion about shows like that and stuff like that. There's a lady doing Game of Thrones reviews, which I really, really enjoy, me personally. Because I just need to be getting the breakdown and understanding of what the fuck is going on with TV shows and shit like that. So, but I don't watch TV like that, so I'm trying to get the Stranger Things. People tell me that's good. So I'm starting season one. Oh, Pete, that would be so good. Oh, that's what we're going to do on my channel, y'all. That's what we finna do on my channel. But damn, should I start from season one and do every episode? What y'all think? Should I do every episode? Yeah, it's looking good. I'm so mad. I really want to just hold off and complete the live. What I'm gonna do also, when I get like my equipment, like my computer fixed and stuff like that, well, I'm having to get a whole new computer. Because getting this fixed is going to cost the same amount. But I'm going to edit the videos and I'm going to repost certain parts of my wives back on YouTube so we can relive the lives. You know what I'm saying? The best moments of my life. Because that shit was funny as fuck when I was doing the Disney Plus. With Disney Plus. Oh my God. That Disney Plus shit took myself out. Like, I'll be going back on my own live listening to this shit. I'll be making myself mad. Dang. And I've been having an issue with this phone too. This bitch don't want to charge. This bitch don't want to do nothing. Like, I get a charger, the phone stopped liking the charger. But what it is my phone don't want me to use the charger while I'm on it. So I guess that's fair. Oh shit, I got YouTube on my fucking Nintendo Switch. I'll be... Hey, hold on. Hold on. I'm so mad right now, y'all. It was getting good for me. And we was almost at the end too. And outside of it almost being at the end, her video was only 13 minutes. It was really longer than I was talking, but I don't know. I done lost my momentum. So this is what we're gonna do. We're just gonna end the live. I really appreciate everybody that strolled by. We've been on this bitch for 2 hours, rolling, laughing, having fun. I appreciate everybody that stopped by. Make sure you leave rainbows in the comments before you go. And I appreciate you guys all for stopping by. I will go live tomorrow. And I'm going to get back to making some short videos for you guys. some funny videos. And like I said, give me suggestions, because these YouTube streets, this sector that we in is low-key boring. I could talk about the same shit 100 times, though, and it make it sound different and entertain y'all. So it's never nothing. It's never nothing, okay? But, you know, these people are boring. And they ain't got nothing going on. Like, girl, nothing. See, the difference between the mukbang community and an actual content creator is that there are people that actually have personality and creativity, you know? So when you watch your favorite YouTuber or something like that, it's 9 times out of 10 because they're entertaining. So with the mukbang community, anybody could be a mukbang. You just gotta turn the camera on and eat. You really don't even gotta say anything. You can just eat on camera. And boom, you're a mukbanger. Quote unquote, a content creator. So a lot of the people that just eat and, you know, they don't have a personality. I feel like low-key Beloved made the mukbang community more of what it was because she brought personality to mukbang. Before they were just eating a whole bunch of food and stuff in their mouth. You watch the Asian mukbangers, they be eating all kind of crazy. You know? Girl, I said goodnight, I might not even go. I'm trying to start with a phone again on. Lock my damn momentum now. I'm trying to like build it back. Because I really want to finish the damn video. Because what I can do, when I start editing stuff, I can edit all the stuff that I'm talking about right now and then just continue the video and then end it. I'm going to edit all this shit. I'm going to like make folders on my YouTube so it'll be organized. Like all my lives will be in one section. All my little short clips will be in one section. We finna clean house and have it looking right. But yeah, these bookbinders, they don't all have personality. They're just random people that everybody doesn't have a personality, guys. The world is a big world. Everyone has a personality, but everybody doesn't have like that it factor that takes them to the next level personality wise. And that's all it is. There's nothing wrong with Dalvin and Carson and Nicole. It's just that they just really aren't like, Dalvin's really cheesy. Nicole's really like, I feel like Nicole's just not herself. I feel like she will probably like, I feel like she's a period happy kind of girl for real. I feel like, you know, with Darius, like it seems like Darius brings out everyone's personality more. And that's how I am when I go around people. I bring, you know, people get real comfortable around me. But, and then, you know, a lot of people, you see their issues and stuff. If Dalvin was making content and telling, you know, Ellie to turn around and just content, he always mean everything he say and stuff like that, he should have did it like how Mr. Kyle Avocado does. I don't like watching him. Because even if you're playing and being toxic, it, to me, it's a good book. I can't miss things. You're doing a lot. But at least make it look like content. You know, and then he said that he's a little parody they did, Day in the Life of a Mukbanger. That motherfucker was so boring. Even when they do like certain things, he wants it, like how the girl said he's controlling, he wants his YouTube to be all picture perfect. He comes in like, hey guys, Ellie, what are you doing? And then they just be like, hi, Dalvin, and they act it out. I don't like that. Take two, take three. Nigga, me and Ellie is going on a date. Hey, you know, do your, what are they doing? Do that shit. You know, and say, hey, we in this thing. We finna go on a date, da 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 da. Everyone gotta be so fucking like all the acting and nigga, it's YouTube. Not Zeus Network. YouTube. Like, even on Zeus Network, they be doing bad acting. Like, girl, they be bad acting for somebody else. You said Dalvin was thinking about shooting when he said mukbang. He do. That man is obsessed with guns and bangs and loud noises and shit. Girl. Gang bangs, all kind of shit that man into. All kind of bangs. banging Houston Bottom. Like, girl, as long as it's a bang, he here. God damn, my phone ain't coming up. So, the phone acting up, y'all. I'm finna go. Sorry, we couldn't bounce back, but I really enjoyed y'all company. And if you like, if you enjoyed the live, go ahead and bless the Cash App. It's called Rainbows. And with an S at the end. And I'll see you guys later. So, bye, guys. Good night. Have a good night.